It's time to talk money, but not the one we're giving to you or us taking, but the budget to run this country. 13.588 trillion naira is the budget for 2021, up for spending with 505 billion naira. That's from the National Assembly. This was approved yesterday. And we want to talk about all that has to, as much as we can, you know, jamming to the time that we have, and to help us make sense of this one, particularly how it relates with the extension of the deadline for the 2020 budget. We have joining us economic analyst Mokhtar Mohammed. It's a pleasure to see you again. Good morning.
Good morning. Always a pleasure being on Plus Africa.
Yes, indeed. Right. So I don't know. Let me just chip that in and then we could take it from there. Are the two budgets going to run concurrently? Please explain to us that don't know how this works. A budget for 2020 was extended to March, and then we have another budget approved for 2021. Will they run concurrently, and how would this affect the January to December cycle?
Well, we said it last year that they hurriedly passed the budget to make sure they meet the January to December cycle. And remember that there had been a bill that was passed before by the 7th National Assembly or the 8th National Assembly that always extends the budget, especially capital expenditure, by 6 months before the approval of the new budget. I think that's what they are just doing. So what they are looking at now, they don't want any project to stop, because some of what, again, the law says that if you pass the new budget, that means the most approved, those other projects might stop because there will not be funds for them. They have to return those funds back to the Federation accounts. So they don't want that. So that's why they are saying, look, for capital project, we're going to extend it by 6 months again, so that at that time, work will keep on going. So by the time we have this 2021 budget come in place, so it will just streamline it and just stream with it and just go ahead. I think that's what they are trying to do. That law has been there. That's why we keep on complaining that there was no need to hurry into the hurry to pass the budget. Let's do due diligence in the budget, and so that we won't have it, because we've already set up the law that all capital project and recurrent expenditure in the other after the expiration of the budget, if the new one is not passed into law, can still be ongoing. I think that's what they are just doing. It's nothing new. They've done it before. They're just doing it again.
That means this January-December cycle is a no issue then, because if we're extending the implementation and you're also going to be budgeting for some of these capital projects, I mean, I'm speaking from a plainly layman's perspective. There is no point, really. We could have waited until March to pass the 2021 budget, so we continue that way.
Yes. Ordinarily, I think we are just trying to make sure we have this January to December. And I keep saying it, every country has to fix its own financial year, and we don't have to do January to December. But a lot of people just think, oh, no, some companies are there that don't do January to December. They do March to March. Some do June to July. Some do July. So it's all depends. But we want to play by the global practice that says it's January to December. That's why we are where we are now. So, but I don't think it defeats the purpose of January to December. Let you know that some of these projects that we're saying that they will be running concurrently with the budget are not projects that are going to be giving funds. And you're talking about the Lagos-Ibadan, you're talking about the Mambila Plateau project, you're talking about the Onitsha Bridge project. You're talking about all of these projects. These are projects whereby each year there's a particular amount that is earmarked for this project. So it's just a continuation. They don't want those projects to stop. I think that's the more reason why they are doing what they're doing. Just add, if those projects are continuous projects that will have been put into a plan for the next 4 to 5 years. So it just go on streaming. I believe that's what they're doing. Right. We've not seen details of the project yet.
Mokhtar Mohammed, I'm sure you know, you maybe, of course, remember that the January to December conversation was politicized at some point. It was also seen as one of the breakthroughs of the current administration, you know, bringing us back to a January to December cycle. And so maybe that's why they are, you know, fighting to keep it that way. But I want us to talk, you know, of something that is never really spoken about, and that is the percentage of budget implementation. every year passes, and you know, if you look closer, you might see that implementation of our budget sometimes never gets up to 40%, sometimes 50% if we're lucky. I don't know if we've ever done 50, but it's never really spoken about. And we're now, of course, getting into a new budget without seeing how far we've gone with the 2020 budget and what we did achieve with it. If you can quickly speak on that and then also share your thoughts on debt servicing more than 3 trillion naira in this budget. How does this work? Does it scare you?
Well, let me talk about your first question. Definitely, that's why we have our representative there. They're supposed to make sure that this budget is implemented to the latter. But unfortunately, politics always take the center stage when it comes to budgetary in Nigeria. So we always have that problem. The only state that have been able to implement budget to about 70 to 80% is Lagos State. And you know why they do that is because the house is totally controlled by one party. And so they have a way of making sure that they meet up with their financial year. So a lot of work needs to be done if you want to do that. Like you rightly said it again, when you politicize your economy, then you have the kind of issues that we have now. By the time they will now call the ministries and parastatals to defend some of these budgets, they are not there. Sometimes you hear the minister of parastatals telling that the house, the members of the house, whether the Senate or the other, is asking them for kickback before their budget will be implemented. A lot of things goes behind the scene that we don't know. And that is why we always have this problem. And sometime again, we have white elephant project. Even this current, we're talking about a budget deficit already. And you've seen about 550 billion has been added to this new project because you just feel that the price of oil has gone up and nobody's thinking of saving for the rainy days, because that's why we are in where we are today. Now, going to your second question. What did you say? The second question was
the debt servicing of over 3 trillion naira in the budget.
I am not surprised. We need to pay our debt. We will all be complaining about the debt to GDP that they keep on telling us. Well, many challenges have been the debt to revenue, and so we needed to do that. Now, I need to get a breakdown of that debt servicing, because I want whereby we have to pay the debt to the domestic contractors. If we do that to the domestic contractors, that will help boost our economy. Not that most of our debt, we have not looking towards paying the foreigners. So we should make sure that those debt services are geared towards boosting our domestic debtors, that's our domestic companies. If we do that, then we will not have loss of job. We have projects still ongoing. We have employment. So that might just be the reason why we are having that high figure. But we're still waiting for them to give us the details. Like I said, the challenge we have in Nigeria is not debt to GDP, it's debt to revenue. Yes. How are we going to boost our revenue? And we've seen that happen, that we are now seeing that the tax bracket is being widened. We are getting more money from tax, even more than oil. Today now we see the price of food has gone up. But when you see an increment in one side, you see a shortfall in the other side. Now the exchange rate, at the time they were passing this way, the exchange rate was they put the target at 373. But today the exchange rate will be taxed at 392. And the members of the House or the Senate or the House of are not looking at that. All they are looking at is the price of oil has gone above $50 per barrel. Why are you not looking at the exchange rate? I think that is a major challenge that we have. We will have problem with the exchange rate, and we have problem with trying to save for the rainy days. Our legislators don't think about that. Once the money is there, they begin to input other projects. We have now seen about 550 billion have been added. We will need to get to the details of which of these projects were increased or which local government. Sometimes you just see that a local government project or a state project is not being handed over to state because the legislator wants to be means to be telling the people that I'm actually working for. So we need to get details of this budget, and that lies in the hands of the journalists, with Nigerians, to go and get details, and let's see, make sure that these budgets are implemented. Implementation does not lie in the executive arm of government nor the legislators' arm of government. It lies also in with the people getting interested in the budget, reading through the budget, no matter how voluminous it is, looking at where concerns you and begin to follow up. And thank God we have the social media to be able to follow up what government is doing.
Great point you made with regards the importance of talking about revenue generation. Because if we can't fund our budget, we will, of course, continue to borrow, and you know, nothing really will change.
Yes, I do have a question, though, for, again, to help explain the parameters and physical assumptions underpinning the budget. There's the 2021. How practical are they in the face of this pandemic? Let me quickly highlight a few. The oil benchmark at $40, and then daily oil production estimated at 1.86 million barrels. And then we have the exchange rate. That's the part that is a bit confusing for me. Put at 379 naira to a dollar. Please, could you help us make sense of this part of the conversation?
Let me tell you, the exchange rate at $379 per barrel is already, it's not right. It's not correct, because the CBN have brought the exchange rate to $392 per barrel. So that is wrong in entirety. Oil output at 1.8 million is already wrong, because presently now we are doing about 1.6, so we're already short of 2 million. So now look at all those things. When you look at that, let me get to the nitty-gritty. 379 to 392. What does that tell you? That tells you that there's a shortfall. And what happened in that? That means our debt has gone high than what the National Assembly is looking at, especially our foreign debt has increased by about 12%. They are not looking at that. Now, going further to the, that means now oil price, oil output is already set at one, they are setting it at 1.8 million, and we are doing 1.6 already. Okay. So 2 million already shortfall, about 200,000 shortfall in barrel. So that already is affecting our revenue. Now you put exchange rate, oil price at $40 per barrel. Yes, presently oil is doing about $50 per barrel. Now the legislators, the executive were estimating at they gave them at $35 per barrel or $38 per barrel. That was what, and they are hiking to $40 per barrel. Now we have a second wave of the COVID. We are beginning to see most economy will begin to shut down. So that will bring down the price of crude also. So that's a challenge. When you look at these three parameters put together, that is why the fiscal policies has not been able to have any headway since this administration came into play. Whatever we are seeing in the economy now, whatever is playing in the economy now, has been the handiwork of the monetary policy. Because when you begin to do budgets, and when you are doing budget with fictitious figures, when you are not being details when it comes to budget, especially in the financial system, I'm just giving you two. The exchange rate 317, they are putting at 379, and already CBN is telling us exchange rate 392. That is wrong already. You're putting an output at 1.8 million barrel per barrel. We are only doing 1.6 million barrel per barrel.
Is this a forecast that by that time, since the other budget has been extended, the prices might have come down? Is that a possible scenario? We're in a pandemic. We have a vaccine now. There is a light.
Are you sure the exchange rate would have come down?
I don't think so. But you are the expert. You have a better perspective, and that's why we're asking you.
When it comes to economic focus, the error should be less than zero. Because you are talking about what will affect just a single... I'm just giving 200,000 barrels short already. 200,000 barrels. So then
There's also a GDP growth rate that, you know, that was mentioned at 3%, as also part of their projections. Do you see this, you know, attainable? And, you know, where do we go from
here? Even the CBN, if you heard what they said, that they are expecting a GDP growth rate about 1.9, if everything goes by plan, if we are out of recession by the first quarter, or the second quarter. You see, the legislators are not taking recession into consideration. They are not considering that we are in a recession.
All right. Just before we say thank yous, I want you to quickly speak on this. I know it's a bit small, but it's something I'd like to get your thought on. The Senate President, Ahmed Lawan, said Senate had worked hard to meet the deadline of passing the 2021 budget, and he urged Nigerians to pay attention to the work that the lawmakers are doing and recognize their sacrifices to ensure the nation comes out of recession. So my, as an economist and somebody who is watching the Nigerian political space, how commendable really is this seeming doggedness of our National Assembly members to get the budget back to the January to December cycle? In 30 seconds, if you can.
You see, I'm laughing because I don't see any hard work there. I don't see whereby you are rushing to pass a budget that has a lot of error. And you want us to commend you because you put so much hard work. Why were you put there in the first place? You put there by the people to do the hard work. We have to celebrate you for doing your work.
All right. I guess we'll just leave it there. I just wanted to hear your thoughts. Maybe there's something we are missing and they are asking for us to pay attention to the sacrifices that you're making. Thank you very much, Mr. Mukhtar Mohammed. Always a pleasure to see you. I'll be calling you after the program.
Hello. Hope you enjoyed the news. Please do subscribe to our YouTube channel and don't forget to hit the notification button so you get notified about fresh news updates.